This conference will now be recorded.
I want to welcome all of you who are joining us tonight. If this is your first L2, we hope it'll be well worth your time and your effort. And then actually, honestly, every one that I do, I put a lot of time and effort into the work. And I just believe that the Lord helps us in that, communicating to you something that would help you out. And just like last month, talking about the intimacy, I felt like the Holy Spirit really came in and helped us out last month. All right. So let me begin talking a lot about what's going on with the virus. And again, feel written. We'll do our best to respond to those at the time. Kansas has just about 5 o'clock announced that they will be closing their schools, or the students will not be coming back from spring break to any of the schools in Kansas. So we know that's going on. I know in Missouri, we have in and around Springfield, a lot of the city councils have met or are meeting tonight, and some of them have limited to 50 for sure. Some have limited all the way down to 10. And so we have a lot of that going on. So I understand all the limitations and have been made aware of a lot of that. And so we'll address all of that. So I'm very aware of what's taking place in Kansas and Missouri. I will be meeting with our general superintendent tomorrow. The regional DS is in another meeting, another set of DS is in another meeting. So I have actually 4 Zoom meetings in the next few hours that will be communicating across the Mid-America region, then across the United States on things that we're doing and things that we're not able to do. What in all of this? We understand that we're limited in some if you're coming online, go ahead and mute your phone or computers. That will help us out. If you're coming online, go ahead and mute your phones or computers. That'll help us. So we understand we're limited, but we also understand that we are not a people of fear. We are a people of faith. In fact, is scripture would tell us that we can be people of great faith. And so what we want to do is we want to take a circumstance that looks impossible, and we want to turn it and use it for the glory of the Father. All right. And so we really believe that Romans 8:28 is applicable here, that God can work through any situation as long as we stay focused on Him, and He can use it and turn it to His glory. And we just believe that God can take this circumstance, which looks impossible to some of us, and He can turn it and use it to His glory. He can help you out to do some impossible things in the life of your church. Okay, so we're not going to be people of fear. If you're coming online and you need to mute your, that will help us out. Mute your phone or computer. Thanks. But we're going to be people of great faith, and we're going to do some incredible, great things to the kingdom. All right. So, all right. If you're coming again online, go ahead and mute your phones for us, please, or your computers. Mute them. That way, we won't have feedback. So we just believe we can be creative beyond our wildest dreams. Some of you would know the story of the Crystal Cathedral, where the pastor was doing a great job, and things were pretty tough. He couldn't get enough buildings. He ended up going out to a local outdoor theater, and there he was preaching to the cars, and literally they were hearing him through the theater sound system. Bob Galloway, who is a Nazarene, who really is the one who instituted the small groups for us, picked up on that and remodeled that in his situation, in his church. And out of that, for us, came a small group movement that to this day is still going on, okay? Again, if you're coming on and your phones are on or your computer, you need to mute those. Feedback, and that will help us out. For us, we're getting some feedback. So if Bob Galloway could come up with that idea, then we have to have a mindset that says we can do some incredible things in this time, that we will refuse to be confined or defeated in all of this. We just believe that we can create an Acts 2 movement in our churches. And what I mean by that is not only the role of the Holy Spirit, we can create house churches whereby we are videoing the service and it's going to different houses, different computers, and we're seeing that process take place as we're seeing the church multiplied as it was in Acts chapter 2. Just a moment. So one of the things that we've already had happen is that people who have never gone to church are more inclined to try church through this video process. So I can see where people who have not been to church would have an opportunity to think about coming to church in their living room. So it becomes a thing where you are asking people to invite people to their house, or to say to people, why don't you watch this with me, and then we can talk about it later on. So there's some options that could happen. And I just believe that God's not limited to only showing up in a building. I think he can show up in your home. He can show up on a phone, can show up on a computer. And so I'm trusting that God's come. Two good things. Just what looks like the impossible situation here to do. Change our thinking into some new dreams. It becomes an issue of our attitude. So let me strongly encourage you to have the right attitude in all of this. In other words, rather than an attitude of defeat, let's have an attitude of victory that we can push through all of this and we can come out on the other side. So let me help you out in several areas. One is, if we're gonna continue to push through, every church has to have a media live recorded service in some format. Now, whether that's a Facebook or a YouTube or on their own webpage, I really don't care what you use to get it done. But for over 2 years now, I've been pushing this really hard. That every church would have the ability to go live or recorded on their service. Have to in operation, okay? The second thing that's crucial in this is, one is media, two is financial or electronic giving. So your church is going to have electronic giving in order to receive any. Now, some people may mail in a check. But into now, today's society, that is not going to happen a lot. And so let me give to you, if you have your paper and pen, if you have not yet created an online giving process, let me give you about five or six churches that are doing it. And then I'm going to give you a company that somebody just signed up with today. So the first one is Steve Wireman over at Fordland. They're a church that just started about a year ago. And they are doing Facebook Live. And they have signed up for online. And call Steve, he could help you out. The next giving. You could, church is Garnet up north. They've had their process going and have had it going for a while and have got it kind of fine-tuned down. I know you can call Pastor Jonathan and he would be glad to help you out. Carthage with Pastor Dustin, they have been doing it for quite some time also. And that percentage that they have is fairly low in Carthage, and but they're using a full system on that, and you can talk with Dustin about that. The well, Selena, Pitt Naz with Kyle and his team, both those churches have online giving. And then Bill Whetstone told me just before we got online that he just signed up today with a company, and they waived the $100 fee, then gave him 3 months free, and their interest rate is 2.3 on the credit card or debit card cost. So all of that is really important. No matter what you do, you will lose part of your income. But if you don't have electronic giving, you're not going to get it. So you get it, it'll cost you to have it. But if you work it right, it'll be very minimal. Now, some companies, some of the sites will allow you to have the choice to have a button on there where the lay person or the giver can cover that 2.3 cost. And so it depends on what company you're going with. But all these companies can help you out. Okay, again, if you're coming online, make sure you mute your phones and computers, all right? That will help us out just immensely. So as you set up your finances, let me help you out with one very important thing that will help you. So you make an agreement with a company, and you start to publicize this out to your church, say tomorrow or the next day. I would highly recommend that you help your people lean into automatic withdrawals. Automatic is the reason why. You're going to get money that you would normally not get because of electronic giving. But if you can move them into automatic withdrawals, then you'll have money come in even when they're gone or they forget. So if they go on vacation 2 weeks, the automatic withdrawal will show up in your account and you'll be just fine. If they're gone and they forget, you've lost that money. So I want to just recommend to you that if you're going to push your people in a direction, you're going to lean in a direction, lean towards setting up this designated giving, this automatic withdrawals with them, okay? So the video going live, crucial. Financial giving, crucial. The part we can survive, we might be able to survive with low attendance, but we cannot survive if people aren't giving. And so, let me just say to you to make sure that you're setting up this in some format, because when we have tenants, it's going to cost us. And it's, if you have any building or any debt, this is crucial for us. Okay. Now, here's some possibilities that are going to come out of these next few weeks. Number one is you've got to help your prime timers. If they're like my mom has not left the house and she's not planning on leaving the house until she just has to. So I think there are people who are out there who are thinking towards that. And if the church can help them in any way, let's step into that and help them out. You may have to be able to think towards helping out local business owners. If we step into this, like for instance, for the state of Kansas, all of those who are hourly waged at all of our school systems are not. If they close down everything, have anything the next 2.5 months, it could become very serious for them. And so we have to understand that some of these folks are going to be crushed in these days without income. All right. So take care of our prime timers. Let's maybe have a flash mob for a family and love on them. And then I want to say to you, since you say, well, how long is this? How long are we going to do this? Here's what I think is really important for us. All this. make sure that you don't talk in terms that create this, we're never going to get there to the end. Make sure you're thinking about, okay, so when could this possibly end? And so my illustration for this is over in James River in Springfield. I think that in their situation, come April, end of March, 1st of April, they're going to push really hard to have church. So if things start to temper down, I can see some of the bigger churches pushing, which might open doors for everybody else in these large settings. All right. So let's just work at this a week at a time with our people. Don't lock yourself into the impossible here, but talk about it. You may have to talk about it in staff or in church board settings as what will be our long term. But I'd be real careful about creating any negative connotations with your people and dragging them down on, you know, we're just going to be doing this forever and it's going to be terrible. Okay. Don't talk that way and don't think that way. When we talk about working with our people, I would say to you, in your setting, I think you can have your Sunday morning services. I think you can have them recorded and put out. And I would say, maybe why not have your children, pastor or workers, do the same thing. In other words, another recording that would be a Facebook Live, and it could be your children's ministries. Then on Wednesday nights, why not film a teaching by your children's pastor again, or your children's workers? And why not do one with your teens? So you're ministering to the three groups. So you'd have to create another Facebook Live or another Facebook page for your teens, for your children, for your church, and use all of that. And I could even see some of that being simultaneous if you've done it right. You put them in different rooms. Using Facebook Live, and you have the ability to carry that on your phones, you actually could be ministering to all of your families at the same time. If you have not got the email, we want to make sure you understand that Dustin has decided that through March, at this point, we don't want you to worry about numbers. So the email that he put out simply said, please go ahead and count your numbers. That way we'll be able to compare to say, you know, we averaged about half of our church, or we had this many online, just so you'll know. But we won't report or record numbers. So when it comes down to the end of April, you are not going to have to report this catastrophe of numbers that some of you are going to face. Because if you don't gather and you have zero people, I know some of you, you've had tremendous years and you're thinking this is going to kill everything. Well, we just don't feel like that's fair. So we're saying to you, go ahead, record as best you know, but we're not going to ask you to put in those in the final numbers. So it is possible that the recording numbers could have ended at the end of February. So we'll see how that plays out. But we want to take that pressure off you. That way that maybe some of you are feeling like, you know, it's not going to work. Okay. So don't worry about the counting. And then I would say to you, I would create connecting teams. I would divide out my church into teams or family situations or small groups or Sunday school, however you do that. And I would have somebody always connecting with everybody in church every week. Don't let anybody feel like they have been left alone or left out or forgotten. Most likely, you are not going to win on this deal, okay? Some people are going to say, you should have had church and had faith. Others are going to say, if you had church, you're an idiot. Others are going to say, hey, why didn't we do this, or why we didn't do that, or, you know, nobody contacted me. I haven't been contacted in 8 weeks, 4 weeks, 3 weeks. Nobody cares. And so I'm just going to go to someplace else that cares. You've got to stay connected to your people. So however you want to do that, please make sure you're connecting with your people through this. I sent out an email today that had the Convoy of Hope and Jonathan Hall told me just before we got online that he had signed up for it. And they are giving him extra right now. So if you want to call them and get signed up, there's a high potential that you might be able to get extra food on that whole thing. All right. So that's Convoy of Hope. Then Monday was supposed to be our human sexuality time. We're going to try to move that. We've already asked for a couple of dates. And we've all also are asking for a time during NYI convention, all right, that the same speakers could come and share with us. So probably the one question that is on everybody's heart and mind is, so has the church mandated to us anything? And at this point, they have not. And so you have to do what you think is the wise thing to do in your setting. You know, we've been recommended numbers of limits of 50, limits of 10. Some, like the city of Springfield, they're going to fine groups that were to meet over 50, $1,000 per event. I also know there's some of you that are in rural settings, you're thinking, we're meeting. And I get it. Okay, so we're not mandating anything on this line. The general church is not mandating to you anything on this line. So you can do whatever you think is best, and however your church board leads. But I'm going to guess that most of you, you know, will come to a setting where you probably will follow line with all of that. Okay. Dustin's just telling me that we have not heard yet from the speaker, so we'll have to wait on all of that. Okay. Here's some couple questions coming through. Can you speak to the churches which are small and do not have multiple staff and multiple ministries? Yeah, I can. I think if you can do the online, the two services, I think that would be your win for you. So if you do a Wednesday night service in a small church setting or your Sunday morning setting, I would think about recording maybe a Bible study, putting that online on a Wednesday night for your church. And then definitely your small, in a small church setting, I'd make sure you're recording your morning service, and putting that out, and then maybe having you know, your breakdown is smaller. So you, if it's a church of 50, then if you have 5 people or 10 people to check on that week, that would break down a little bit better for you. Okay. Pittsburgh is saying they use Easy Tithe at Pittsburgh and Columbus, so you can feel free to use that. And what if we increase during this time? And I say, praise the Lord. Okay, that's a great question. Let me read a couple more here that are coming through. Dustin is saying about annual elections, and I'm sure that will be one of the questions we'll hear from the generals, because we know that there were district assemblies that were supposed to meet this week. And so when we hear from the general tomorrow, we'll probably understand, we'll probably hear on how that's to work in the local church. And I'll be glad to ask him. We'll have our jurisdictional GS online, and I can sure ask that question if we were to get into a situation. We may be able to push those elections back So your annual meeting may look different than what you normally do, or you could go ahead and print out all of your reports. You could print out your report. You could send it all out to all of your people. And then as we get closer, when we get past this date, and because our district assembly is in the end of July now, then you may just have to push your election process back. And so we can ask tomorrow if we can work all that out, where we would have basically two separate entities going on, where we have an election that is not in a particular reporting meeting. So that's a great from all. Okay, so question from. Let me see if I'm here to questions that some of you are asking, because there's a bunch. Okay, are we, some of you are asking about sound, and I don't know if the sound is cutting out. Bill's been working on that. So Bill can help me out if he can shoot me a message. If I need to reiterate on something, if some of you would let me know that, that would be great, okay? Someone's writing saying they have another one of the church management softwares is Breeze, Breeze, that they use, and that you can see how that works out. All right. Another one is Stewardship Technology is a giving option. Another one is for live streaming, go to mevo.com, mevo.com. That one is at Gerard. Where they're using Facebook, they put it on their Facebook page. somebody's asking about, could you do a drive-in church? And I don't think there would be any problem with that. I actually had a conversation with another pastor just before we all got online. And they are thinking about going to the high school parking lot, putting up a sound system, and then everybody would be able to hear with their in their car, windows down, have to have it loud enough. But I could see where you could have some type of a drive-in church and it would work. It's a good question and good thought. Another one is Share Faith Giving. That is Ava Highway, Share Faith Giving. And he says, we use Share Faith Giving and have seen an amazing response, especially on our snow days. So anytime there's an absence, there you go, all right? A response to Ken's idea on the movie theater idea. Sean is saying there's some friends who are doing that in Florida and seems to be working out well for them. Another one is Share Faith. What is the monthly cost of Share Faith? And I think all of these do not have a monthly fee. They have a 2.3 charge that is on each transaction. Now, if I'm not right on that, somebody correct me who is listening, but you let me know. Steve Wireman is saying they are paying $1,200 for the year. So that looks like that's a set amount rather than a per transaction, unless it's $1,200 plus the transaction. And Steve, if you're listening, if you go ahead and shoot me a text and let me know that answer, I would really appreciate it. Okay. Okay. Is that all of the questions or comments that you have? Is church membership? Yes, it is. Most of those are church by size that would work. If you just work with the ones who are per transaction, so when I initiated ours several years, that's not a church size. Years ago, business group that was doing pharmacy transactions. And so we got in with just a straight transaction fee. So it cost the church, we lost the 2.3, but it didn't cost the church another amount. Okay. I'm trying to read text and messages that everybody's sending in. Just make sure your online giving can work with your web page. Someone is saying, Steve responded and said, it's $1,200 a year. Whoops, I lost it. $1,200 a year. Okay, hold on. Plus percentage. So his cost is $1,200 a year for website plus a percentage. Okay, so that helps you out. All right. Nathan is saying that they use tithe.ly. So tithe.ly. And it says his is only transaction fees. Okay. All right. I'm trying to stay caught up here with all of this. Sean is saying that the church in Florida uses a radio station to do that. And so the sound quality is greatly improved. And I know Jonathan Hall is thinking about this in Garnett, and they actually have a radio station in town, and they're going to go to him and see if they can use him. Shane Weaver says our website through Share Faith is $600 per year and comes with app and giving included. With app and giving included. Share Faith is $600 per year and comes with app and giving. Bill Hungerford says Dayspring uses ChurchTrack, ChurchTrac, for church administration, and they integrate with Stripe, Stripe, for tithing. No. Tithe, just the 2.9 and 30 C's for the cents for transactions. All right. John is saying that you said Breeze is $600 a year. Charge per transaction. And then it is a 2% through Stripe. It is easy to use, free, and you pay per transaction. So Wes is asking a question here. I understand there isn't a mandate on this time, but is there an official recommendation from the district regarding suspending services in favor of online services? And what we're saying at this point is if we stay within the confines of your city arrest, you know, we're all for you going online. We're confident that you can do that. And, you know, if we need to help you, we'll be glad to help you out getting that done. Are we suspending the services? That really is up to the local church. The general church has not, again, the general church has not put out a mandate on this. So at this point, it's still self-governed. In other words, the local church has the right or the choice, the right to make the choice, what they're going to do. Of course, you know, you're dealing with an issue of falling in line and government and with your local government, local city officials, the government, smaller the town. You remember you're going to be dealing with them later on, especially if you're trying to do things in the life of your church. Okay. Some of them are saying, is PayPal a wise choice? I don't know that answer, to be honest with you. Somebody else says, no, PayPal charges you and the user and also charges a balloon fee, meaning that the more they give, the lower the fee. So I guess there is some surcharges onto PayPal. Okay. All right. Is that all the questions that you have? I sure want to try to do my best to answer them. Anything I clarify? Anything that I've made it more confusing for you. Hopefully not. Everybody good that's listening? I'm waiting for any responses from texting or from here. So I think we've answered everything. Okay, here we go, more. Okay, good. Looks like most of you are okay. Okay, let me just take okay, just hold on a second. Got some more messages. Hold on. Okay, Dustin is asking me if I can all of the input on online giving and summarize all, trying to put in an option. Let me try to do that tomorrow for you. I'll go back through, give you some options or what I think are maybe the best options for you. And I'll shoot you out. It won't be a lengthy email, I promise. It'll just be maybe with the options and the percentages. So those of you who are listening, why don't we do this? Those of you who are listening and you have that, why don't you shoot me a, rather than text, shoot me an email that has the company you're using, the set fee, the transaction fee, and the web page or the software that you're using to make it all work together. So you'd give me four answers. Okay. So those of you who are using that, why don't you shoot that off to me? And that would be a huge help. I'll put that all together and we'll send it out to everybody tomorrow sometime. Okay. All right. Any other questions or comments, thoughts on any of that? Let me just close with a couple of thoughts on all of this. Tracy is saying, and a company contact. Yeah. So if you have talked to a person in that company, why don't you give me the name of your contact person that you talked with, especially if they have given you a special price. So that would be important. Okay, great. Thank you, Trace. All right, let me just close with this thought. And here's my ideal on this. So I want to say this in closing tonight. Is as if we're going to deal with all these major issues in our lives, I think we need to spend time with the Lord to hear what he wants to say. It's not that the small church and the big church, everything that you do will be the same. It's going to be different. But here's the catch. The God that we serve is full of ideas. He's not limited. He's not up in heaven wringing his hands. He's not surprised by what has happened. He is fully capable of helping you and helping me out to get through this. And I believe we can come out of it stronger than we've gone into it. So you've got to spend time with the Lord, hear from him, and then go and do what he's asked you to do, what idea he's given to you, what vision he's planted in your heart, go and do it. So this, let me give you just a quick thought process and then we'll be done, okay? I'm going to use the word theology for this acrostic. And so the word T, or the letter T, the word time, is that you can't experience real closeness with anybody else just in short settings. And time is crucial if you're going to develop relationships. And if that's going to be happening in human relationships, how much more is it important to have time to develop a relationship with the Lord? So the application of this is you got to be patient, okay? You got to be patient. The H on this theology is humility. Scripture says they are proud. He loves a broken and contrite heart. And intimacy is always preceded by humility. That's a great preaching line right there. Intimacy is always preceded by humility. In other words, Jacob was broken before the Lord. The application of that is, sometimes I may have to be broken before the Lord to have this intimacy with him. E, expression. You will not get close to God or anybody else, without both of you expressing yourself in vulnerable, loving ways. In other words, you have to be open and honest. Transparency is crucial here. The application of that is, I must learn to worship authentically. Okay, I love what Brother Manley said at retreat, that if we are going to lead our people in worship, how dare we sit with our arms folded and not lead well? So that singing with all you got, raising your hands, giving everything you got in worship. His idea was, if you haven't gone over your message by now, you don't have it down, it's not going to help you to go over sitting on the platform. Oh, theology. Oh, openness. God isn't found through rigidity or keeping some sort of checklist. Rather, it's by relational, honest, transparent approaches to his grace. The application of this one is, I must be transparent and trust him to be open. Okay. Theology. L, listening. You must learn to listen to his voice if you desire intimacy. Stop talking, but when we stop, we don't lose intimacy when we listen. I invite you to spend time in scripture and time in prayer. Theology. O, obedience. I desire, or a desire to please and a willingness to act are prerequisites. Jesus associated obedience and friendship with him. Learning to love what God loves, learning to love who God loves, is absolutely crucial. G, God is not found by our keeping the rules or performing for him. Intimacy foundation is love, not law. It's gratitude, not guilt. I must learn to let God love me. Why? Last one. Intimacy doesn't happen automatically. You must hunger for it and desire it more than anything else around you. The application of that is, I must want intimacy with God passionately for it to happen. The story is told of the who was traveling by train to his jobs. And in one particular week, he had a 2-week stint that he was going to be gone. And every trip that he left, his little boy would come to the train station and say goodbye to his dad. And then his dad would give him an apple. And because those apples were rare and had great flavor, it was a special treat for the little boy. In this particular trip, the man was going to be gone 2 weeks, and he'd gone to the store and he'd gotten two apples. And he came in to the train station with the little boy, and the little boy was tugging on his pants. Said, "Dad, I really want you to leave." And he was going, yeah, but I got to go, son. I'm sorry. And he said, but I got you two apples this time. He said, "Oh, one, I got you two, and I hope you'll like them." And he handed them to the little boy. When he did that, he turned and got onto the train, sat down by a window seat, and he looked out, and he saw his little boy there on the pavement. And the little boy was sobbing through his tears. And he, in the sobbing of his tears and his hands up to his face, he dropped the apples. They lay on the concrete. And the dad was reading the boy's lips as he said, "Daddy, the little apples, I want you. Daddy, I don't want your apples. I want you." And I think God would speak into our lives tonight, and he would say, "I don't want your apples. I want you." And whatever it takes for you to have an intimate relationship with God, I trust and pray you'll do just that. Can I pray with you before we close tonight? Jesus, we love you. We refuse to be people of fear in these days. We will be people of faith. We will not step back. We will step forward through the strength of the Spirit. We are not going to give up. We're not going to quit. We're not going to back down. But we're going to stand in the strength of the Spirit. And we pray, God, you would infuse us with all that you are so that we can be all that you want us to be in these days. There are opportunities for us to touch a world and change it. And I pray, oh God, today you'll help us to open our eyes, change our hearts and our attitudes, and you would use these weeks to make us better so we can reach our world for Jesus. We long to advance the gospel. We long to see the gates of Christ, hell pushed back. We long to do all that you're asking us to do. Help us to see every opportunity to help others, prime timers, people who are in tough days, people who need a friend. God, open our eyes to potentials that are unlimited because you are an unlimited God. And we thank you for that. Now, would you walk with our pastors and our leaders, guide them, direct them, infuse them with your Spirit, and use them in these days for your glory. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right. Let me just jump real back and look at questions. You guys are firing off the questions again, so let me ask one more time. How do I feel about church? Church vans still picking up small group settings. Well, if we stay with what they're recommending and we stay within 10, most vans aren't going to hold that many. So, you know, that would be up to you. You still have your distance rule and all that. You just have to be really careful, I guess, how you would do that. I'm not for sure quite how to answer that one. That's an interesting question. You know, you could just ask people to bring them or to get together, as long as you kept them, you know, within the numbers, or you set them in places where they were distanced to watch the presentation. Someone's asking about the installation in Indy. No, actually, I'm going to be in Bradleyville Sunday morning for their service, and then we're going to fly over to Independence for that installation at 4, and that's going to be online, and so or however they work that, and so we're going to do that. So thank you for those of you who already sent us information. We appreciate that. And I'm looking to make sure. Okay, I think we're good. So if you've got questions, give me a call. I tell you to have a great, great night. And thank you for joining us tonight on the. Let me know. God bless. And all of you going as two. And if I can do something for you, grace as you lead well.